Now let us concentrate on some family. Based on our discussion, we can go through the formula. See, depreciation is nothing but the gross minus net. Domestic plus net, that is NFIA, is equal to national product, gross national product. Net indirect taxes is equal to indirect taxes minus subsidies. So whenever you want to determine depreciation, gross value minus net value will indicate GDP minus NDP will indicate depreciation. Similarly, domestic value plus net factor income from abroad will result national product. Net indirect taxes can be calculated as the difference between indirect taxes and subsidies. Market price, factor cost plus net indirect taxes will result market price. Factor cost is equal to market price minus net indirect taxes. Then we can go through various things. That is, GNP on the basis of market price will be GDP on the basis of market price plus net factor income from abroad. GDP on the basis of market price can also be determined in another way, that is GNP on the basis of market price minus NFIA. Like that, if you go through the formula, it will be easier for us to determine the national income or the concerned calculation in respect of problems. So, how to calculate national income under different methods? See, if you recall, under product method, gross value added is the criteria for which we have to add, sorry, we have to consider value of output, and from that we have to eliminate intermediate consumption. Then net value added is nothing but gross value added on the basis of market price minus depreciation. Then net domestic product is the difference between net value added and net indirect taxes. National income on the can be computed under product method on the basis of the sum of these two, net domestic product, that is net value added on the basis of factor cost plus net factor income from abroad. Similarly, under income method, national income can be computed as the sum of these things, that is compensation given to employees, operating surplus, mixed income of self-employed people, and NFIA. Then in respect of expenditure method, there are some possibilities. GDP on the basis of market price can be computed by using a formula, that is final consumption expenditure plus gross domestic capital formation plus net exports. Net exports is nothing but exports minus imports. Similarly, GNP on the basis of market price can be computed on the basis of the sum of these two, GDP on the basis of market price plus non-factor income from abroad, sorry, net factor income from abroad. Then gross national disposable income can be computed on the basis of GNP on the basis of market price plus net current transfer received from the remaining part of the world. And this one, GNDI, national consumption, can be computed on the basis of national consumption expenditure plus gross national saving. Private income will be computed by using this formula. Income from domestic product accruing to the private sector plus NFIA plus transfer incomes. So, to determine transfer payments, personal income plus corporate tax plus undistributed profits. let us try to concentrate on some application oriented questions given in your study material. If you take the first question, there are some details like consumption 750, investment 250. Let us assume it as crores, rupees in crores. Government of purchase 100, exports 100, imports 200. And you are asked to compute national income. So if you go through the question, consumption, investment, purchase, all of them are based on expenses. So under expenditure method, we are asked to compute national income. So whenever expenditure method is given, we have to apply a formula, consumption plus capital formation plus net exports. Net exports refers to exports minus imports. Here exports value is 100, imports value is 200, therefore it becomes minus 100. Whereas consumption is 750, investment and government purchases are 250 and 100. So when you add the first three items, 750 plus 250 plus 100, it becomes 1100. And the value of net exports will be minus 100. So 1100 minus 100 will become 1000 crores. So that is the national income according to the expenditure method. That is worked out like this. That is CIG, that is consumption plus investment plus government purchase plus net of exports plus exports, net exports. X refers to exports and M refers to imports here. They have assumed like that. So when you add the first three items, it results 1100 and net exports amount to minus 100. So 1100 minus 100 results thousands. 1000. Then see the second problem. Calculate GDP at market prices and derive national income from the given data. You have been given inventory investment 100, exports 200, indirect taxes 100, net factor income from abroad 50, personal consumption expenditure as 3500, gross residential construction investment 300, depreciation 50, imports 100, government purchase of goods and services 1000, gross public investment 200 and gross business fixed investment 300. So whenever this kind of thing is available, again the question is on the base of expenditure method. So first of all, we must try to find out what are all the expenses, and for that purpose we can calculate GDP on the base of GDP on the base of market price should be computed. So how will you determine GDP on the base of market price? Personal consumption expenses plus gross investment plus gross residential construction investment, government purchase, etc., and finally net exports have to be added. So and GNP, whenever you want to determine GNP on the base of market price, it is on the base of GDP plus NFIA. GNP on the base of market price minus indirect taxes will result GNP on the base of factor cost. GNP on the factor cost minus depreciation results net national product or national income on the base of factor cost. So first of all, we must determine GDP on the base of market price. அதுக்கு எதெல்லாம் ஆட் பண்ணோம் அங்கே என்னென்ன இருக்கு பாருங்க க்வெஸ்சனில். பர்சனல் கன்சம்ஷன் எக்ஸ்பெண்டிச்சர் 3500 இஸ் தேர். கிராஸ் இன்வெஸ்ட்மெண்ட், கிராஸ் இன்வெஸ்ட்மெண்ட்டுங்கிறது இங்கே நிறைய இருக்கு. ஒன்று வந்து கிராஸ் ஃபிக்ஸட் இன்வெஸ்ட்மெண்ட் 300, கிராஸ் ரெசிடென்ஷியல் கன்ஸ்ட்ரக்ஷன் இன்வெஸ்ட்மெண்ட் 300, தென் கிராஸ் பப்ளிக் இன்வெஸ்ட்மெண்ட் 200, இன்வென்ட்ரி இன்வெஸ்ட்மெண்ட் 100. இது எல்லாத்தையும் கூட்டினா 900 வரும். தென் கவர்மெண்ட் பர்ச்சேஸ் ஆஃப் கூட்ஸ் அண்ட் சர்வீஸ் க்வெஸ்சனில் 1000 இருக்கு. நெட் எக்ஸ்போர்ட்ஸ், நெட் எக்ஸ்போர்ட்ஸ்னா நான் ஏற்கனவே சொன்னேன், எக்ஸ்போர்ட்ஸ் மைனஸ் இம்போர்ட்ஸ். எக்ஸ்போர்ட்ஸ் மைனஸ் எக்ஸ்போர்ட்ஸ் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா 200, இம்போர்ட்ஸ் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா 100. ஸோ நெட் எக்ஸ்போர்ட்ஸ் வில் பி பாசிட்டிவ் பேலன்ஸ் 100. ஸோ ஜிடிபி ஆன் த பேஸ் ஆஃப் மார்க்கெட் ப்ரைஸ் வில் பிகம் 5500 க்ரோஸ். அடுத்து நம்ம கண்டுபிடிக்க வேண்டியது நெட் ஃபேக்டர் இன்கம். sorry, net factory income from abroad is also given in the question, which is 50. So to namba kandupidikka vendiyathu GNP, GDP on the base of market price kandupidichitom. GNP on the base of market price kandupidikkanumna GDP on the base of market price minus NFIA. So sorry, NFIA must be added. Here it is mentioned as minus 50. So GDP on the base of market price 5500, minus 50 results 5450 crores. Then GNP, gross national product on the base of fixed cost. To determine that, from GNP we have to eliminate indirect taxes. So indirect taxes are mentioned as 100 ER. So 5450 minus 100 results 5350. Then from GNP on the base of factor cost, when you eliminate depreciation, that results NNP on the base of factor cost or national income. So automatically you will be getting 5300 crore rupees as national income for the second product. So what about third question? See, in the third question you are asked to determine GDP on the basis of market price and GNP on the basis of market price using the income method, that is second method. Show that it is the same that obtained under expenditure method. So first we must compute national income on the basis of income method, and we must prove that we are getting the same income under the next method called expenditure. நம்ம என்ன பண்ணோம்னா எக்ஸ்பெண்டிச்சர் மெத்தட்ல வரதும் இன்கம் மெத்தட்ல வரதும் சேம்ங்கிறத ப்ரூவ் பண்ணணும் இந்த சம்ல. பர்சனல் கன்சம்ஷன் 7314, டெப்ரிசியேஷன் 800, வேஜஸ் 6508, இன்டைரக்ட் பிசினஸ் டாக்ஸஸ் 1000, தென் இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட் 1060, டொமஸ்டிக் இன்வெஸ்ட்மெண்ட் 1442, கவர்மெண்ட் எக்ஸ்பெண்டிச்சர் 2196, ரெண்டல் இன்கம் 34, கார்பரேட் ப்ராஃபிட் 682, எக்ஸ்போர்ட்ஸ் 1346, net factor income from abroad 40, mixed income 806, imports 1408. These are the details given. இதுல என்ன பண்ணனும்னா, when you go for income method, இதுல என்ன பண்ணனும்னா GDP on the base of market price கண்டுபிடிக்கணும். அதுக்கு என்ன பண்ணலாம்னா, இந்த compensation எல்லாமே, employee compensation என்னென்ன receive பண்ணிருக்காங்களோ அது எல்லாத்தையும், income receive பண்ணிருக்காங்களோ அது எல்லாத்தையும் add பண்ணிக்க வேண்டியதான். Wages and salaries, employees contribution towards security schemes, profits, rent, interest, mixed income, of course depreciation, net indirect taxes. Net indirect tax மட்டும் நம்ம compute பண்ணிக்கணும். Indirect taxes minus subsidies results net indirect taxes. So in this problem the sum of 6508 plus 34 plus 1060 plus 806 plus 682 plus 1000 plus 800 results 10,890, that is GDP on the basis of market price. இதோடு எதை add பண்ணும்னா, net factor income from abroad, which is 40, அதையும் add பண்ணும்னா, 10,930 is the GNP. GNP on market price is GDP on the basis of market price plus NFIA. So, அதுதா national income எடுத்துக்கலாம், income methodல. So, இதும் expenditure methodல calculate பண்ணும்து, equal நம்ம prove பண்ணும். Expenditure methodல என்ன, consumption, investment plus government purchase or capital formation plus net exports. இதில் பார்த்தீங்கனா, consumption 7314 இருக்காந்து questionல, 1442 investment வரும், 2196 இதல்லா இருக்கும், net exports பார்த்தீங்கனா, exports minus imports, 1346 minus 1408, which results 62. So when you add all these together, 10,890, that is the GDP on the base of market price. What is required for us? நமக்கு தேவையாந்து பார்த்தீங்கன்னா, GNP, gross national product on the base of market price. அதுக்கு again, என்ன பண்ணோ, we have to add NFIA, net factor income from abroad, which is 40. 10,890 plus 40 results, 10,930. See, one more problem we can see, which is, of course, you are asked to compute GNP at market price using value-added method. Value-added method is the first method. So, what are the details given? Value of output in primary sector 500. Net factor income from abroad. Minus 20. value of output in tertiary sector 700, intermediate consumption in secondary sector 400, value of output in secondary sector 900, government transfer payments 600, intermediate consumption in tertiary sector 300, and intermediate consumption in primary sector is mentioned as 250. That is in of course rupees in crores. So when this kind of problem appears, how will you work out or how will you compute the national income? See, under product method or value added method, we must add all the values of output in various sectors, primary sector, then intermediate consumption of primary sector, similarly secondary sector value of output and the secondary sector and its intermediate consumption, then that is of course value of output in primary sector minus intermediate consumption, value of output in secondary sector minus intermediate consumption, value of tertiary or service sector minus intermediate consumption. So net value added from the subsectors must be taken into account. So in this case, value of output in primary sector is 500 minus intermediate consumption is 250. Similarly, value of output in secondary is 900 minus intermediate, that is intermediate consumption in the secondary sector is mentioned as 400. Output in tertiary sector is 700. Intermediate consumption of tertiary sector is 300. So 250 plus 500, 750 plus 400 results 1150. The pathing na theriyum. 500 is the total output minus intermediate consumption in primary sector 250 pochana, balance 250 varum. Value of output in secondary sector 900 minus intermediate consumption 400, so balance is 500. Value of output in tertiary sector 700 minus intermediate consumption 300, inga or 400, so 400 plus 500 in secondary sector plus 250, 900 plus 250, 1150 is the GDP on the base of market price. Namage theva GNP. GNP on the base of market price is nothing but GDP on the base of market price plus net factor income from abroad. Net factor income in the question la add pannom, but we got negative value, which is minus 20. So 1150 crores minus 20 crores results 1130 crores. So like that you can also try the balance problems and the similar kind of problems given in your study material.